take our plans and we are going to write our three big idea paragraphs. But before we can do that, we have a couple things we need to do. The first thing I want to show you is that this was one of our students' pre-assessments when we wrote it, our persuasive essays at the beginning of SLAM. This person had a really nice big idea paragraph. And I'm going to read it to you. And then I'm going to have you do some noticing. What do you notice that it has? What's good about it? What could they improve? So let's read. It says, another reason is that MSTEP and NWEA make us smarter. How would we get smarter without those tests and work our brains? Also, how would teachers know we're getting better? What do you notice that I added a lot more words than what was just on this paper.
Yeah.
would suggest pointing. So one reason why school should be online is so that work can get done faster. I think that I could get more done working online than in the classroom because I read really, really fast. Do you see how I'm pointing? You point to your big ideas and your evidence as you're telling your partner. If you get confused and you're like, I don't know how to start, or I don't know what I should do, talk to your partner. Your partner can help you. So as the partner, your job is to listen. As the reader, your job is to make sure that you try and make it sound interesting with complete sentences so that they want to hear more. So you and your partner, okay, go ahead.
I kind of understand.
Sometimes she was looking down at her paper and reading the words from the paper, and sometimes she was kind of looking up, adding more. Did you notice that?
Yeah.
That's what good writers do. They take their plans and they use that to help with their thinking, but they add even more details. Let's have one more share. Jane, come on up. Start my paragraph with socializing slash friends. How can I write that as a full sentence?
Socializing and friends.
Wow. So how could we change that into a complete sentence for her?
Think about how this person might have done that.
That first sentence, what could she do? Instead of just saying socializing and friends, how could we stretch that to make a really good first sentence? Because we have no idea what we want to say, it makes it very tricky. So, what we are going to do now is we're actually going to do this target. We're going to take this plan and we are going to make not one, not two, but three big idea paragraphs. And this is how we're going to do it. It says, I know I'm successful when I can, which finger up number one.
Number one.
Reread my plan.
Reread my plan.
Hey, we've done that, haven't we?
Mm-hmm.
You could do it again at your seat. That would be helpful. Number two.
Number two.
Indent before writing.
Indent before writing.
You noticed that with that student joining. Number three.
Number three.
Write my big idea as a complete sentence.
Write my big idea as a complete sentence.
Right? We're not just going to say friends / socializing. We might say one reason. That kind of thing, right?
Right.
And then number four.
Number four.
Write my tell me more as complete sentences.
Write my tell me more as complete sentences.
Just like how you talked with your partner, your job is to write in complete sentences. Don't just take the words from your plan and write it down. That'd be pretty boring and it wouldn't make sense, right? You need to add in more details. Give me a thumbs up if you know what your job is today. Thumbs down if you're like, I'm still a little confused, I need some help. All right, if you have a thumbs up, you may head to your seat. If your thumb is down and you need a little bit more help from me, stay on the carpet.